Hey, look, let's just have a real conversation, remove our biasness and all that. It might be time to start really sizing up if gangster rapping is a legitimate way to go about making a living, having a gangster rap career, making gangster rap for money. Now, some people will probably say, yeah, it is legitimate. You know, it ain't against the law. Like, just because, let's just have a real convo. Just because something not illegal, just because you won't go to jail for something, don't mean it, you know, that don't mean that it's right. You can do a lot of things that's not against the law that you won't get arrested for, but it can still be something that's wrong, something that's just, you can, but just throw a little example out there. Here, you can cheat on your husband or your wife. You ain't gonna get arrested for it, but is it right? Like, did you do something good? Nah. So we can't measure this by, my question is, because that's what people would say, sure, it ain't illegal, you know, it ain't against the law. Other than that, what else? Like, what is legit about it? All right. Obviously, you know, the name of the video is when a rapper get killed. I made this video because whenever a gangster rapper get killed, right, in remembrance of that person, in honor of that person, when people want to recollect about that person, they play that person's music. Now, look, when that person get killed, everybody, rightfully so, and I think people are genuine when they say it, man, why this keep happening? This needs to stop. You know, black on black violence, gun violence, this, that, doesn't, so, right? Legitimate. And I think everybody genuine when they say it. But the reason why that person got killed, somebody shot them, you're about to honor that person and remember him and try to have good memories about him with music that's talking about the same reason why he got killed, if he a gangster rapper. Gangster rappers gonna talk about violence, guns, drugs, whatever, what have you. What gangster rappers talk about. Really think about that. You are genuinely messed up behind this man getting killed, and the things that caused him to get killed, you genuinely saying, man, this needs to stop. But that very reason why he got killed, you're about to go play that music in honor of him, even though it was to his demise. What if somebody OD'd on some heroin, some fentanyl or something, right? And to honor that person, everybody was handing out videos or pictures of that person shooting up or snorting or whatever. But they say they really against people using fentanyl and ODing on heroin, if a man is messing up community. They genuine when they say that this person died from it. And then say, man, let's remember them. You know, let's do something for them. Everybody starts shooting fentanyl. Everybody pass out pictures of him, you know, shooting up or snorting. Think of how. Think. This is why. That can happen. This is why a gangster rapper can get killed in a gangster way, and in remembrance of him, everybody play his gangster music, which was his demise. It can happen because, just like that drug example I gave, right? People don't do that when somebody OD. You know why? Because most people not strung out on drugs. Most people not on drugs, but those who are fans of gangster rap music, they are on the music. The drugs make you feel, when you take it, you get a certain feeling. It make you feel a certain way. It remind, you know, that feeling get attached to certain things that can remind you, that can remind you of certain things. Same thing with that music. It make you feel a certain way. That feeling that you get is attached to other things, and that can remind you of certain stuff. You're not on the drugs, but you on the music. That's why you wouldn't dare show videos of that person shooting fentanyl or snorting up. But you would co-sign remembering that person through his gangster rap lyrics, which was his demise in the first place. Think about how twisted up that is. You co-signing the very thing that you're against when you do that. Another thing, people probably feel like a gangster rap career is a good way to make a living because of the conditions that person came out of prior to rapping, right? It's like this. It's like, let's say you got a bunch of people who playing in mud, right? Then you got a couple of those people who get out of the mud, go next door and play in some dirt. Since you went from playing in mud to playing in dirt, it looked like a come up. But the fact of the matter is, they still dirty. They still got wingworms, the whole nine. It's just that nobody ain't mixed no water with their dirt over there to turn it into mud. When somebody muddy, you can see the mud stuck on them. They look a little bit more filthy than somebody who been playing in dirt. But don't get it twisted. That person's still in dirt. That's really not a, it looked like a look to somebody in mud. Let me tell you right quick, tell you a good example of this right here. I got a friend, right? He work around kids. My friend went to work one day. They had this older lady, I think she might have been in her 60s, he said, came up to him one day with tears in her eyes, asking him what happened. She was genuinely distraught. And he asked her, what you mean? What you talking about? She said that she was flicking, through the channels at her house, minding her business. And she stumbled across something called the BET Award. It was one of them rap award shows. And she was talking about how, I saw the young ladies up there, they had this on, they was doing this, they was doing that. It almost, the lady was tearing up. You know why? Because that lady, when it comes to music, not in mud or dirt. She got a real perspective of how things supposed to look. To the point where she about to start crying seeing people play in the mud and some people playing in the dirt. Not to somebody playing in mud and somebody playing in dirt. Her perspective, she just don't know. No. That's mud and that's dirt. She ain't tripping. She right. She got a real perspective. She got a clear perspective about this when it comes to the gangster rap music. Don't nobody believe that those conditions that created people to talk about the gangster rap music is good. Nobody believe it. So why music promoting it, celebrating it, glorifying it is good? It's not either. And really, and I talk about this in another video I made called Legal Trapping. Once you go playing that dirt and make the gangster rap music, you probably way more vicious than you was when you was trapping or when you was stugging in your hood, because your reach was small. You was limited to whatever area you was in. Once you make that music that's influencing their minds, changing them lives, you got millions of people under the sound of your voice who going out there and act out the stuff that you used to do. Or co-sign the stuff, even if they don't go out and act it out, go out and co-sign the stuff that you used to do. This is really not a good way, a constructive way, a legitimate way to make a living. When I say legitimate, I ain't talking about legal. I'm talking about what's right and what's wrong. This is negative. So another thing that I hear people talk about, and I talk about this in another video I made called War Amongst Rappers, right? people say you talk about music, gangster music, but you don't talk about movies. First of all, I would say whatever you watch, whatever you listen to, try to understand what about it drawing you to it. Try to understand how it's influencing you or affecting you so you can know, okay, this is not good for me, or okay, it is okay for me to watch and listen to with anything, because both of them can have influence. I agree with that. This is the difference, though, between music and movies, although both of them have influence. Music get the benefit of the doubt for being real. Movies don't. That's why we talking about gangster. If somebody a gangster rapper, if they ain't living out what they say, he's considered a fake rapper. They gonna call him fake. Music get the benefit of the doubt for being something that somebody done been through. Something that they know somebody they might have been through that. Something that might have happened in the area or whatever. People giving music the benefit of the doubt for being real. When you go to a movie, first of all, the people are called actors. It's understand that they're pretending. When you go to a movie, you're going to automatically assume it's not real. To the point where if they want to let you know, no, actually this one is real. They'll tell you. They got a flash based on the true story in big bold letters, or no one will believe it's real, because people don't give the movies the benefit of the doubt of being real. That's one of the differences. I talked about the main difference, in my opinion, in another video I made called Raised by Music. But just think about that. Is gangster rap a legitimate way to make a living? When I say legitimate, ain't talking about legal. I'm talking about, is it right? Is it productive? What is it doing? Is it, besides making a person some money who making the music and the people who funding him. You know, them few people get money, but all these other minds and souls get to get influence through the negative music. Because it's negative. You don't agree with nothing that the gangster rap music talking. You don't think none of it good. It ain't right. It is what it is. See the invisible stuff.